Hey all, Mac here, also known as Macattack, with my sister Kookie, also known as Kookie Wookie.
Hello.
We're here to try out a new game, and I want to get you guys as involved in this game as we can, because this is going to be a game where you guys are going to vote for, between the two of us. It's going to be a competition between the two of us. Very chivalrous competition, you know?
A little bit chivalrous.
Yeah, okay, nothing. Anyways, it's going to be an improv game. And basically, it's a game I've been working on, and we're going to kind of test it on here and see how it goes. So, basically, the concept of the game is very simple. You see, it's a storytelling game. One of us is going to be the narrator. I'm going to start us off with this one. And the other one is going to be our actor, who has to play all the roles in it. Now, the trick with this, though, is that we have three types of cards. We have theme cards, which basically tell us of a setting or a type of story or something like that. We have character cards, which gives us different kinds of characters that we need to work with. And then we have plot points. And plot points are basically just things that make the plot more interesting. Could be an item, it could be a sort of emotion, a contest, something like that. So to start off with, I'm going to realize that I forgot a coin. Which makes this kind of hard, but basically...
I'll just yell heads.
That's what Kai does. We're going to have one of us draw one of each of these cards, and then we have a 50-50 chance to grab an extra either character card or plot point card. And from that extra card, from those four cards, we need to try and come up with a story. We have 30 seconds to prepare, and then we have to come up with a story, which our actor is going to act in.
Yes, brilliantly.
And hopefully not mess us up, because this is going to...
I'm definitely going to mess you up, definitely.
Oh dear. Sorry.
Anyways, so I'm going to start off with, you know what? Okay, so if you don't guess the number in my head, it would be between
Wait
one and
a
two.
Second, this
between,
is totally not fair.
Between one and two.
If you don't
guess the number in my head, okay, then it'll be plot point. If you do guess the number, it's going to be character card. So tell me what number it is.
Four.
I said between one and two.
One and two?
Yeah, between one and two. I'm 50-50 chance here.
I still say it's four. I know the way your mind works. Two.
Two? Okay, it's a character card. So, we will grab.
I think he just did that.
One theme card.
I don't think there was any actual battle.
Only one theme card. One, two character cards.
I think you're just pulling this out of your head.
And one plot point card. I had to pull this out of my head. This is improv. We have nowhere else to go to but my head.
So you're narrating. Shouldn't I have pulled the cards if you're narrating?
Does it really matter?
You're the one with the 1-2 system.
Are you judging me as being unfair? So, our theme is science fiction. So, we got science fiction here. our one character is an alien, which is fitting. And our other character, unfortunately, is an actuary.
What are the chances of that?
And...
good.
Our plot point is the high school prom.
I knew it would be the prom. I was like, is it the prom? And it's like, yes, it is the prom. An alien and actuary in a science fiction film go to the prom.
Okay,
what are the chances?
Give me about 30 seconds here, and then...
I don't even know how I'm supposed to act this.
It's going to be interesting. We're going to make this up as we go. So
I over your water bottle.
We'll have 10 minutes to tell the story. If by the end of the story I want to continue on...
You don't.
Then... I really don't. Then we will have to continue on, but I will have to draw another either character or plot point card to add into the next part of the story.
I feel like this is just making my life a living hell. It's like, now you get to be an old farmer, too, at the prom.
I have to be nice to you because you get
your... Could it be like the British proms?
You get your revenge on me after this.
Oh, okay. As long as there's revenge, that's all right.
How to do this. Okay. I
do
think
some chocolate?
I need a lot of chocolate for this one.
I don't even know what's coming, so I think I have it way worse than you do.
All right, I'm going to start the timer. And here we go. Once upon a time, on Space Station Zelta Delta X-Ray Charlie. And I have to remember that, don't I?
Hopefully not.
It was time for the intergalactic prom to come up. The alien Zorglox sat and shifted in her chair nervously. She didn't know how to do it, but she had to do this today. She had been telling herself all year that this day would come, and she would tell her love of the year that...
I change every year. And you are my love of the year.
This is high school. I mean, we can go along with
this. It's like more of the month.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Sorry.
That she was going to confess her feelings and ask out Tommy to the prom. As she approached Tommy, who was studying to be an actuary in college, Tommy sat on his calculator, looking at the staircase.
He sat on his calculator.
I said sat looking at his calculator.
It sat on his calculator and looked at the staircase.
He's not very good at his work, folks.
I don't trust him already. Keep going, sorry.
Looking up at the staircase, he pondered some musings about the quality of safety of the staircase.
I'm not entirely sure that this staircase is sound. It starts at a 270-degree angle, which could cause people to trip and fall on their heads in this anti-gravitational sphere. In fact, I'm even more concerned why we have a staircase when we don't have gravity. Makes it kind of tricky.
Zorglox tried to interject, but her longing whispers lay underneath the calculations of young Tommy.
75 and 43 and 23 and parsed by 5 and 5. I love you. Always you pay attention to me. My heart beats with the sound of a million zeros and ones.
Much to her heartbreaking, both of her heartbreaking, actually, she saw Tommy walk up the stairs deep in his thoughts. Calculator stuck to his rear.
Boo, I'm walking up the stairs. I miss my love. I wish he'd notice me. I know I'm just another android, but my two hearts beat with all the passion of 16 hormonal teenage girls at a Justin Bieber concert.
By Jove! What has the military created?
Monstrosity that loves boy bands.
I believe this is too dangerous for society to deal with. Determined that this was her only chance in her life to find true love, Zorglox chased after Tommy, only to trip over her slightly extended extension cord and fall down the stairs.
What does the fox say? Ding, 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 ding. Oh, that smarts.
When her system finally rebooted...
rebooted?
She was stunned to see Tommy staring over her inquisitively.
Oh, the chances of you falling downstairs with no gravity is pretty much 2 billion to 1. In fact, there's a better likelihood of having an android robot with two hearts and the desires of a 300 teenage girls at a Justin Bieber concert. You are fascinating.
Could this be her moment? Could this be her chance?
This could be my chance.
Unfortunately, moment. Tommy simply nodded as he wrote down his calculations and walked away. Not one to be discouraged, Zorglox picked herself up, set her MP3 functions to Bieber, and chased after Tommy one more time.
I can't remember any Bieber songs. Can I sing One Direction?
Everybody I will allow it.
Everybody wanna take my heart away.
It's JC. You better hurry, I can't sing.
So, chasing down the hallway, she finally caught up with Tommy, calling out his name.
Tommy. T-0-M-M-Y. T-O-M-M-Y.
Tommy reluctantly turned around to see what was calling his name.
I don't even know what they're calling. What's T-O-M-M-Y? I think that's the new exchange student from the Russian space station. T-O-M-M-Y.
Barely able to keep her circuits from overloading, Zorglot saw this as her opportunity. She calculated 1,000 ways that she could ask Tommy out.
There were exactly 1,432.56 ways that I could ask Tommy out, and only 5 of them could possibly work.
Having her calculations finished, she zoomed back into reality, only to realize that her downloading processors were too slow, and now the day was over.
I should have upgraded to Windows 10, but I did not. Internet Explorer, how have you failed me?
Dejected Zorglox went home.
Deject, deject, deject. The file cannot be found. Deject, deject, deject.
Putting on her loveliest aluminum dress, she
very cold.
Reluctantly made her way to the high school prom.
I'm feeling mighty blue. Oh, ooh, ooh, you.
Once there, she sat drinking her oil punch and wondering what it was that she could be doing to recover this lost cause of tonight.
Bartender, could you get me another punch, please? I'm feeling so bit blue. Correction, you.
I think we need to check on the mixture of that oil to fuel ratio.
Drowning my sorrows.
But then, with a tap on her metallic shoulder, causing an audible twanging noise, she turned around to see Tommy standing there, pen in his hand. Inquisitively, Tommy asked her if she wanted to discuss the fall she had so that he could use it for his final paper to get into the Intergalactic Actuary School.
The velocity of what you just did was fantastic. I can't even imagine how a robot that is supposed to be brilliant was able to accomplish such a feat of aerodynamic impossibility in a zero-gravity state.
Wow. It wasn't quite the prom dance that she was wanting to, but Zorglox went off, happy to spend the evening with Tommy.
It may not be the happiest of endings, but at least I get to dance the jitterbug with my best friend Tommy.
Luckily for Zorglox, Tommy one day eventually realized that having a computerized girlfriend who could calculate things at a sort of interesting rate was very useful for an actuary.
Yes, it is not for my outside that he loves me. He says it's the inside that counts.
Which just goes to show that in the end, a smart girl will beat a Bieber fan any day.
Everybody wants to steal my girl. That's not even Justin Bieber. Nobody is perfect.
The end.
Bye-bye.
Bye. I'm not really sure how that went.
So, leave us a like and subscribe. Tell us what you guys thought. We are going to be rated based on the quality of presentation and the quality of creativity of the storyline, given what things we worked on, and the fact that we managed to incorporate all the cards into the story.
Please do not rate beneath the level of 0.
Because that is mathematically impossible. I love the way you think. 00110.
Anyways, guys, see you next time when my sister Cookie will be the narrator and I shall be the actor. So hang in there and have a good one.